Hello dear friends, today I want to show you how to install the KitLogger Pro application on Android 13 and newer devices. Before installing KitLogger Pro, we need to disable the Google Play Protect. Launch Play Market, click on this icon and open the Play Protect. Here, all settings should be disabled, because Play Protect identifies our application as spyware and immediately offers to remove it. We can download KitLogger Pro from the download page on kitlogger.net site and select KitLogger for Android. Then choose the KitLogger Pro for Android. You can scan the barcode using a barcode scanning application or click the download link and then transfer the application to your Android phone. If you have a barcode scanning application, you can scan the barcode. Click the link and enter the CAPTCHA code. The application has been downloaded. Let's install the application. Its name is System Android. We click the Done button because the Open button is not active. Next, we need to launch the settings and accessibility. Then we click Installed Services. This is Android 13. It has several features. Here we have a System Android application, but it is not active. We need to tap it at last once for this window to appear. On this window, we need to click OK and switch to Settings, Applications. Find the System Android application. It is at the bottom of the list. Click it. Click on these three dots and select Allow restricted settings. Enter your password. Then go to Accessibility and Install it services. The Android system should already be active. Click it and switch it on. Then tap Settings and click the Activate Application button. Allow the System Android application to take pictures and record videos. We choose While Using. The Access to Coordinates. Enable this in Settings and allow it all the time. Also, permit it to record audio while using. Access your phone call logs. Allow all these settings. Next, we should enable usage data access. Find the System Android application and switch it on. Enable administrative access. Test screenshot feature. If on this window there is no option of never ask again, it means it will show this message every time the KitLogger tries to take a screenshot. On Android 10 and later, this window will appear after every restart, so we do not recommend using screenshots on newer phones. To set up a callback, you can enter any number and click Test Call. The phone application starts calling. And it is good. We can be sure that the callback will use the phone application. This is important because other applications like Skype or Viber can also make calls, but callback can only work with the phone application. To record passwords, you can install the Android keyboard. However, the system does not allow the installation of new application in KitLogger Pro. we should click the settings, switch it on, and install it. After the installation, we should make the Android keyboard the default screen keyboard application. Once done, go back and install the support Android application. This application is the screen reader module, and we need to install it. After the installation, activate support Android. It will open the accessibility and installed services. We can see that support Android is not active, so we need to tap it. When this window appears, click OK. Go back to Applications and find the Support Android application. Click it. Find the three dots. Allow restricted settings and enter your password. Then, return to Accessibility, find the installed applications and switch on the Support Android. Next, allow Support Android to operate over other applications. You can enable both System Android and Support Android in this window. Allow them to ignore battery optimization to ensure they work in lower power mode. To access notifications, click and allow it for System Android. These three buttons will remain on the window because Keylogger Pro cannot detect whether this option is enabled or not. Next, connect to server. Select server to upload. Here you can select Keylogger, Staff Counter or a local server. If you choose a local server, you can enter any URL address to upload the data. Select Keylogger and enter your account email address and phone or child name. Click OK. The connection was successful. Our application has received a device ID, a unique identifier of the device on the server. We can see a new virtual device that has appeared on the dashboard page, and it is labeled encrypted Android 13. Go back and click Prevent launching this activity. To relaunch the Keylogger application, use the phone dialer, enter asterisk 123456 and DS and call. This will open the main window of the Keylogger Pro application. Click the menu and then Get Config to receive a new configuration from the server. Refresh the page and we can see the notification about the encryption. The name is now M32 Android 13. Click Get Config again to receive the encryption keys. Now all the gathered information will be encrypted. You can see some information here that is not encrypted yet, because when the phone collected this information, it hadn't received encryption keys yet. We can reproduce some activity. For example, we can see news from CNN and hear some YouTube music. Now, if we refresh the page, we can see more information. We saw something on YouTube, and there are some web addresses. If we turn off the decryption here, we can see that all this information has been encrypted since a specific timestamp. Before this time, it was not encrypted, and from this time, it was already encrypted. We can turn on the decryption. Now we can verify if it takes photos. Now from the front camera, let's check how it records calls. We can make a call to another phone. Let's say something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we can check if the voice recording was uploaded. It hasn't been uploaded yet. And we can see no screenshots. We should wait for a few minutes. We can verify if it records information in our Viber chat. Now we can see the photos were uploaded and some information from our chat and voice recording from our call. That's how it works. If you want to uninstall the monitoring application from the phone, open the settings. If we directly open the applications and click on System Android, it closes the window. It is a protection against uninstalling. First, we must open accessibility, then find installed applications and support Android. Switch it off. Now we can easily uninstall all the applications. Find System Android, uninstall it. And confirm with OK. Then uninstall the support Android application. That's all. Now the Keylogger Pro application is uninstalled from the phone. However, there is no information about the uninstallation on the server. Here we can see the accessibility settings. Usually, users don't open accessibility, so if we see it, this means the application was correctly uninstalled from the phone. That's all. If you have questions, you can ask me in the comments to this video.